Good morning, children. Welcome to the Lucid Study. Today we are here to discuss the model paper 3 of chemistry senior inter AP. Give the hybridization of sulfur in the following. He has given you some molecules and is asking you the hybridization. The first one is SO2, sulfur dioxide. Sulfur is a central atom and two oxygens, they are bonded with the double bonds having a lone pair of electrons. When the double bonds are present, it is sp2 hybridization. So the sulfur undergoes sp2 hybridization in SO2. So based on the structure also, we can give the hybridization. If double bonds are there, it's a sp2 hybridization. Come to the next one, that is SO3, sulfur trioxide. Three oxygens are present now. Sulfur is a central atom. Three oxygens, they are bonded to the central atom in the triangular manner. Hence, even now, a double bond is present, hence it's sp2 hybridization. The sulfur atom which undergoes sp2 hybridization in SO3 molecule. The next is SF4, sulfur tetrafluoride. Sulfur is a central atom, it is bonded with 4 fluorine atoms and it's having a lone pair of electrons. The hybridization of the sulfur in SF4, it is sp3 dehybridization. The next is SF6 molecule, sulfur hexafluoride. Sulfur is a central atom and 6 fluorines, they are bonded in an octahedral manner and it undergoes sp3d2 hybridization. The sulfur atom in SF6, that is sulfur hexafluoride, the hybridization is sp3d2. The next question is, noble gases are inert. Explain why the noble gases are inert in nature. Noble gases are also called as 8th group elements or 0 group elements. It involves helium, neon, argon, krypton, xenon, radon. So these are the elements involved in the noble gases and these are inert in nature. Inert means stable in nature because it's having 8 electrons in their valence shell and that is called as octet configuration. Having 8 electrons in the valency shell is called as octet configuration. Due to that, it is stable in nature. The next question is, what is Mischmittel? Give its composition and use or uses. In Germany, the Mischmittel means mixed metals and it is an alloy of the rare earth metals. And the composition is 55% of the cerium, 25% of the lanthanum, 15-18% of the neodymium and other rare elements. Once again, children, the composition of the Mischmittel, it is 55% of the cerium, 25% of the lanthanum and 15-18% of the neodymium. And other elements are also present, that is the other rare elements. And the use of this metal, that is Mischmittel, it is used as a deoxidizer. Deoxidizer means removing the oxygen and it is used in the vacuum tubes to remove the oxygen. The next question is, what are the components of the nucleic acid? The components of the nucleic acid, it contains the 5 carbon sugar, a phosphate group and a nitrogenous base. The nucleic acid, it involves the DNA and the RNA. In the DNA and the RNA, these components are present. That is, a 5 carbon sugar, a phosphate group is present and a nitrogenous base is present. The next question, the last question in your section A, it is, give the structure and IUPAC names of monohydric phenols of molecular formula C7H8O. He is asking you, with this molecular formula, give the possible structures of the monohydric phenol and their IUPAC names. Benzene is C6H6. So from this formula, I have used C6H6. The remaining one carbon is there. I am using it as CH3 and oxygen is also there, O and H. That is a phenol group. This is phenol and it's a methyl group. The numbering is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So with this formula, we can make a structure like this. It's a monohydric phenol. The name of this, the IUPAC name of this, it is 2-methyl phenol. And the same thing, benzene with OH group, I am changing the position of the methyl group. Now you just look at what position the methyl group is present. In the third position. So it will be 3-methyl phenol. And the last phenol with CH3 at the fourth position. It is a 4-methyl phenol. So these are some of the monohydric phenols and the IUPAC names of the following: 2-methyl phenol, 3-methyl phenol, and 4-methyl phenol.